Another problem is because there's so much hacking that goes on, there's so much security tied into the internet that sometimes it makes our job, especially when we're on location, extremely difficult getting around all the security measures that are necessary to be put in place because of what people do.
So quick question on security. And I ask it because I was just featured on Forbes.com talking about cybersecurity, but from the biz dev point of view. Do you have a security officer for your company to try to make sure things are, you know, as secure as possible? Maybe not an actual officer, but like a director of cybersecurity, they kind of protect your data and the streams and making sure that things don't get hijacked.
Yes, we have systems in place for that. And it's some of the vendors we use, but yes, we do.
And do you think that's ever more critical now? Because remember back in the beginning of when the pandemic started, you know, you would get a lot of Zoom trolls, people that just, you know, figured out the other strings and jump into there, then they had to boost up their security. Have you had any instances like that happen to you, or have you been lucky?
We've been lucky and we haven't had those instances. And the way to prevent that is basically, especially when we're on location and we're using an IP address, there's all the ports are closed. So someone can't just jump into it with incoming traffic. And then if we have people working remotely, we have to put requests in for a specific IP address to a specific port for traffic. And that's pretty much how it goes.
Yeah, no, that's pretty good. But back to I know I sidetracked you there, but back to the original question then, security aside, how do you think live streaming has changed as a whole? I mean, I think it's more acceptable. I've had some people on the show, and it's my personal belief too. I mean, I think live streaming webinars is here to stay because I think people realize, like, yes, there is a lot of value going on site, meeting people at some events, but it doesn't make sense for other events for you to be there, especially if you only need to see a segment or two. It's like, hey, let's just tune in through the web. Hybrid's here to stay.
So let's take business meetings for an example, or corporate meetings, right? Live streams. So no longer do you need to go to wherever the meeting is, right? As long as the key people that are putting the meeting on are all in one spot, and they don't even have to be, but if they are, it can be streamed global to a global audience. And so one, it keeps the cost of the production down because you're not flying the whole company into one spot. You don't need to rent a hotel space. You can be more, as a worker in that company or an employee of that company, you can be more productive because you can still be at the meeting while getting whatever business you need to get done. You can be home with your family that night in most cases, right? So there's so many plus sides that there's no way it's going away. I think it's only in its infancy.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, again, I think the only negative is you do lose that networking experience, the ability to meet people that you've never met before, or somebody that you've always wanted to meet, or, you know, especially from the sales point of view, the biz dev point of view, that to me, that's why I started TrickByte Biz, because, you know, maybe I would have met you at some event that you were putting on, previous to COVID. But now that COVID's happened, I mean, I haven't been to one conference at all. You know, the only way I get to meet people is through our amazing audience on YouTube and Spotify, iTunes, Verbal, everywhere else, as well as people like you that come on to the show. So that was my answer of, well, how do I continue to grow, learn, network? Because I tell you what, I get people like you on the show and I learn a ton of cool stuff, and it keeps me in the know, ahead of the curve. I think that is the one ingredient that is missing. I don't know if you've ever tried, you know, the virtual networking stuff at all, but I think that sucks.